recently there was a function at Ayodhya at the Sri Ram Janmabhoomi to mark the first anniversary of the Bhoomi Pujan for the construction of a Divya Bhavya Sri Ram temple at Ayodhya. Now, some would argue, why is a temple important in today's day and age when some say the focus should be perhaps on building more hospitals or schools or engineering colleges?
No, one is not saying that you shouldn't build hospitals and colleges, and those are being built, right? The number of medical college seats, for example, have more than doubled in the last 5 years. But one of the things our ancestors taught us is that to have a complete life, you need 4 purusharthas. You need artha, which is not just wealth. It's erroneously translated as wealth. It's wealth, fame, power, everything. We need to be a powerful country. So you need artha. You need kama, which is all the sensual pleasures of life, not just eroticism. Music, dance, everything, right? You need dharma and you need moksha. You need all 4 to lead a complete life. And the temple is the heart of our dharma. The temple is where we connect with our divine. The temple is where we connect with Lord Ram.
We need to connect with our roots, is what you're saying. We need to take pride in our rich history, in our vibrant culture. Generations have been brought up perhaps to think that all of this is make-believe. For example, the Pushpak Viman that we read about in the Ramayana. Now, history has taught us that the first flight was by Wright brothers in 1903. So, what was the Pushpak Viman all about in your view, Amish?
Look, the way I see it, there are things that we learn about from a metaphorical perspective, and there are things which are actually the history of science. Now, one of the things that many people don't know, there was a scientist in India who actually discovered the theory and actually showed it in practice a few years before the Wright brothers. But most of us Indians don't know this, right? We are not taught our own sciences, our own mathematics. Most of us don't know that Bodhayana discovered the Pythagoras theorem before Pythagoras did. Most of us don't know that plastic surgery was indeed practiced in ancient India. It is described in the texts of Shushrut and Charak. And there is a class of Indians which will believe things only when Westerners record it. So the first recorded nose reconstruction surgery in the modern world was recorded by a Westerner 300 years ago who recorded an Indian surgeon doing it on a soldier of the Maratha army 300 years ago. So a Westerner recorded it. Our metallurgical, our navigation technique, we had, people keep saying, we are told that our ancestors never wrote anything down. We were an oral culture. It is utter bullshit. You know, there are 3 million ancient Sanskrit manuscripts that have been tabulated by the National Mission of Manuscripts. That's more than the rest of the ancient world combined, by the way, combined. The number of ancient Greek manuscripts is just 20 to 30,000. Our ancestors, 3 million. Despite the Nalanda University being destroyed, Takshashila being destroyed, most of those texts are actually not religious texts. They're scientific texts, mathematical texts, physics, chemistry, medicine. We haven't studied our own sciences, so we don't know. We don't know the achievements of our own ancestors, and we're not building on it. The fault is with our education system, which needs to be reformed ASAP.